Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the revision topic of chapter number 8, that is human health and diseases, and the topic is lymphoid organs. Okay, we have already discussed it in detail, but then also we need to revise it so that you can understand very well. So lymphoid organs, what are lymphoid organs? Before that we need to understand what is the role of our immune system, right? So if you see over here, immune system of the body is providing us immunity. Getting it? What was immunity? As I said, that it is the capability of the body to fight against antigen or pathogen. Right, antigen can be foreign particle or any toxic substance which is going to harm our body. So this is actually immunity, and immunity is always provided by our immune system. So immune system is the system which first of all recognize the foreign particle which is entering into the body, then response is given back to it, and then what is that? There is a storage of the memory which is responded. Okay, so next time when the same pathogen is encountered, at that time there will be very quick response. So immune system is related to action against, right, pathogen or antigen. So immune system recognize first of all, then respond, and remember, right, recognize and response against antigen, okay, that can be pathogen. So this is the work of the immune system. Now if I say where this immune system is playing a key role, so immune system is very important in three cases. Immune system is very important in three cases. First of all, first is allergic reactions. Okay, next one is autoimmune diseases. Okay, and the third one is organ transplantation, right? At these three places, okay, we have already discussed all these three topics in detail where this immune system is playing key role, right? But this is just a overview that it is playing key role in these three things. First is allergic reaction, right? When immunity is slow or low, it definitely affects the body. How? Because antigens or the allergens, right, sensitivity increases as immunity is low and our body shows allergic reaction. Same way autoimmune diseases, if our immunity attacks or our antibodies attack self cells, at that time also disease can occur. And organ transplantation, immune system has a characteristic that it can recognize the self and foreign particle, and by that when the organ is transplanted without the HLA testing, at that time there is a chance of graft rejection. So these are three very very important. Now immune system are provided to us by lymphoid organs, certain cells, certain tissue, and other antibodies that are called as proteins, right? So we are going to discuss about the lymphoid organs. Now lymphoid organs are those organs where origin of lymphocytes occurs, where differentiation of the lymphocyte occurs, where proliferation of lymphocyte occurs. That are three things. So lymphoid organs are the organs where formation, then next I say that differentiation And the third thing which I said is proliferation occurs. Okay, so these are lymphoid organs. Now, lymphoid organs are characterized into two. First one is primary lymphoid organ. So, students, if you see, in case of primary lymphoid organs, there are two types of organs in primary lymphoid organs. But before that, what are primary lymphoid organs? So, over here, immature lymphocyte gets matured, that is differentiated into antigen sensitive cells, right? So, over here, what happens? Immature lymphocytes undergoes maturation. What happens? It undergoes maturation and it becomes antigen sensitive cells. Okay. Now you are very familiar with the lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are type of WBC. There are five types of WBC. In that, lymphocyte are type of WBC, and you are also knowing lymphocytes are of two types, B lymphocyte and T lymphocyte. So primary lymphoid organs are related to B lymphocyte and T lymphocytes. Let's say first one is bone marrow. Okay, bone marrow is a soft or spongy tissue which is present between the long bones like humerus and femur. So let's say over here, first lymphoid, primary lymphoid organ is bone marrow. Now bone marrow is a site where all the types of blood cells are formed, even lymphocytes, all the types of blood cells, right? So site of formation of all types of blood cells. So students, you need to understand which lymphocyte. Remember, blood cells means RBC, WBC, platelets, everything is going to be formed in bone marrow. So which lymphocytes? Now this is the place where certain lymphocytes get matured. So those lymphocytes which are getting matured in bone marrow, that are referred as B lymphocyte. By the name of bone marrow, these lymphocytes undergoes maturation in the bone marrow, they are referred as B lymphocyte. Now second organ, primary lymphoid organ, is thymus. See, thymus is the organ which is having a peculiarity. At the time of birth, it is large and gradually it decreases in size and reduces to a very small size at puberty. When a person reaches to the puberty, it becomes very very small. So in this case, thymus large at the birth, large size at birth, and gradually decreases in size. Okay, understood? So as our age passes, our immunity gets decreased. Why? Because the maturation of T lymphocyte occurs in thymus, and when the thymus has been reduced in its size, definitely our immunity is going to get decreased. So let's say gradually decreases, and at the time of puberty, this reduces to very small size. Okay. Now thymus is the place where it undergoes maturation of certain lymphocytes which are called as T lymphocytes. Okay. Now see, B lymphocyte is going to provide us humoral immunity, means antibody related, and T lymphocyte is going to provide us cell mediated immunity. So this is about the primary lymphoid organs. Now second is secondary lymphoid organs. Okay, so let me clean this and we will start it. Now again let's discuss about the secondary lymphoid organs. Secondary lymphoid organs are those organs, right, where lymphocytes migrate to the certain organs where they interact with the antigen, and when the interaction is occurring they become effector cells. So mature lymphocytes migrate from this maturation occurred in primary lymphoid organs. Now they are migrating to secondary lymphoid organs where they interact with antigens. So there will be proliferation, means increase in number of cells, right? So proliferation, they will proliferate and become effector cells. Okay, so this is the case of secondary lymphoid organs. Let's say which are secondary lymphoid organs. So you can take example as spleen, right? Then you can take Peyer patches, appendix, tonsils, right? These are the, then mucosal associated lymphoid tissue, MALT, you can take it, right? Then most important is lymph nodes. These are the examples of secondary lymphoid organs. Now let's say we will discuss some, first one is spleen. Okay, now spleen itself is a bean shaped organ. See over here, there are two types of cells present in the spleen. Remember this, it contains two type of cell. First one is phagocytic, means it can engulf the foreign particle, and lymphocytes which can give response to the antigen. So there are two types of cell. Now it is also, spleen is graveyard of RBC, means worn out RBC will get deposited in the spleen where it undergoes denaturation. So over here it is graveyard of RBC. Now it is also reserve storage of the RBC, right? So it acts as a blood vein, reserve storage of RBCs, right? So it is playing a role as a blood vein. Now second one is that we are discussing is lymph nodes. Okay, lymph nodes are found in entire lymphatic system. Where they are found in lymphatic system. Now those pathogens or those foreign particles which are entering into the lymphatic system or in the lymph, they will be trapped over here. After getting trapped, lymphocyte will interact with this, respond to the antigen, and it will destroy, either it can neutralize. There is a case, right? Okay, it can either neutralize or it can destroy. The thing is, lymph nodes trap the pathogen or antigen entering into, as I said, lymphatic system. Now after that, so that what happens, so that lymphocyte can interact with it. Okay, last one is MALD. From this, many times in NEET examination questions are asked, what is MALT? MALT is mucosal associated lymphoid tissue. Okay, mucosal associated lymphoid tissue. Now this tissue is present in the inner linings of major tracts, right? So let's say where they are present. They are present in within lining of respiratory tract, then digestive tract and urinogenital tract. Okay, so this is the location of the mucosal associated lymphoid tissue, that is within the lining, so inner linings of the major three tracts from where pathogen can make the entry. Over there this tissue is present. This mucosal associated tissue, 2017 NEET NEET examination, mucosal associated lymphoid tissue forms how many percentage of lymphoid organs or lymphatic system? So it forms 50%. So this was all about the today's revision topic, that is lymphoid organs. Thank you.